40% of female in India. So it imparts that 90% of female with heart failure must be handled. Mentioned earlier, chronic ID by itself, even if there is presence of anemia, not impairs oxidative metabolism, cellular energetics and immune mechanisms, which causes structural and functional change in myocardium, which leads to reduction in every function, and it also reduces oxygen storage in myocardium. So, we move on to the trials. Most of the trials were done on intravenous iron replacement in heart failure, and most commonly used was ferric carboxymaltose. First trial was FAIR-HF, Ferritin Assessment in Patients with Iron Deficiency in Chronic Heart Failure. It was a double-blind randomized study which had a duration of 24 weeks. The primary endpoints were functional capacity as assessed by NYHA and functional score and patient self-reported perception of well-being. So, 459 patients were taken with heart failure which had NYHA class 2 or 3 and ID deficiency as mentioned earlier, ferritin less than 100 or ferritin 100 to 300 saturation, transferrin saturation less than 50%. With anemia or without anemia, both were randomly assigned to a stool intravenous ferric carboxymaltose. The regimen was decided by Genzoni's formula and FCM equivalent to 200 mg iron per week for iron replacement was given and then every 4 weekly for maintenance. Results were seen after 24 weeks.
Every 4 weeks?
For maintenance.
How long?
For 24 weeks. The study was for 24 weeks.
24 weeks?
Yes,
sir. 200 mg minus per week. 100 mg by FCM.
So, how much is it? 100 and how much?
100
by
FCM.
How much? How much? How much?
That was for 24 weeks. FCM increased ferritin levels in all patients and only increased hemoglobin in anemic patients. FCM improved patients' global assessment, that is, perception of well-being and NYHA class, both were primary endpoints. It also showed beneficial effect with quality of life and 6-minute walk test, and this was irrelevant of the baseline anemia. There was no significant effects on all-cause mortality or first hospitalization. Second part of this trial is FAIR-HF2, which is still continuing, which is considering this all-cause mortality and first hospitalization. That means this trial? The screening included?
Both the trials, they given the why the oral iron therapy was not used.
So there was a trial for oral as well? Oral is
no, I have not heard. This is both the trial. Why only IV iron? And that is to say every weekly to be given for 24 weeks, 52 weeks. It's a difficult job for the patient.
Five, then this patient is in very bad shape of as far as iron stores are concerned.
if this patient is on antiplatelet and if you don't take the UGI scopy and you are giving iron, so again it is going to loss, right? So never jump on IV iron unless you are sure that patient is not losing it. So which type of iron deficiency you have to check? खाली आईवी आयरन आप जो वार्ता पूरी किया रहे हैं तब
सर आयरन इज अ काइंड ऑफ लास्ट थेरेपी अपार्ट फ्रॉम अदर एंटीफिलियर थेरेपी
सी दिस इज ओनली गिमिक राइट जब सर भी तो ओरल आप वन होने नो सो इट्स अ वेरी बेसिक थिंग और हमारे ट्रायल जो है इफ पेशेंट इज एनीमिक एंड पेशेंट इज हार्ट एनी हार्ट कंडीशन फॉर दैट मैटर यू नीड टू ट्रीट दैट एनीमिया यस बाय व्हाटएवर मीन जितनी अर्जेंसी हो ये प्रमाण है Right, you may need to give blood cells also. PCV भी आपको पड़ेगा वो एक फुट और वो वॉच हुए तो, right? So IV iron specifically focus is entirely marketing because it is costlier. Simple. FCC बनाई दी दूसरे, ऐना पहले से सोचा और पेपर प्रूव कर दी जाते, and it works also, but unless you go for the reason of iron deficiency, there is no fun of treating. Not to you, not to patient. Just पैसा पैसा पैसा.
आपने कोना क्राइटेरिया नहीं अंदर HP less than 50 means आपने तो बद्दा इंजन है.
बद्दा
जाएगा जो हम नीचे HP less than 15 है. Screening नहीं अंदर.
Seriously आपने 15 है अगर आपके ना screening है. Inclusion criteria तो less है.
Yes.
Oh भाई.
Inclusion criteria less than 15 है आपने बद्दा
है. सर आपने दे भी लिया ले चलो.
एक तो बात करें सर कि तेलों को HP पर क्वांटिफिकेशन करियो नहीं HP गमे तेट लो भाई आयरन डेफिशिएंसी से क्यों
आया HP तो सिर्फ इज द मिसरीडिंग थिंग फॉर आयरन डेफिशिएंसी टू बी फ्रैंक विद यू विद नॉर्मल हीमोग्लोबिन यू कैन हैव आयरन सो इफ अगेन आई ट्रीट इट विद द आरबीसी यू नो लाइफ विद मैटर्स इट इज 3 मंथ लाइफ એટલે આજે આયરન ડેફિશિયન્સી થાય અને આયરન ના લે તો 3 મહિના પછી એનો હીમોગ્લોબિન ઓછો
So there are three phases of iron deficiency in the sorry say the iron depletion by but it effective erythropoiesis and then anemia after so HP upar jo on matlab nahi right
even carry upar bhi jawan jawan inflammation hoy to khabar nahi ke heart failure ni andar inflammation ketlu hoy che yes and andar man la to ferritin elevate thau jo
actually par sir tame heart failure sathe consider karo cho ne khali iron deficiency karta hoy ne to HP no matlab nahi but if you are considering heart failure तो પછી સર HB જેટલું ઓછું હોય એટલે હાર્ટ ફેલિયરના સિમ્પટમ્સ વધારે હોય એટલે એ વખતે જો HB
સાથે યમ અગેન યુ નીડ ટુ કીપ ઇન માઇન્ડ ઇફ યોર પેશન્ટ ઇઝ હેવિંગ એની સોર્ટ ઓફ એડીમા ઓર હાઇપરવોલેમિયા યોર HB ઇઝ ડાઇલ્યુટેડ રાઈટ સો HB ઉપર ફોકસ કરો અગેન એન ઇશ્યુ નંબર 1 નંબર 2 ઇફ ઇટ ઇઝ અ ક્રોનિક હાર્ટ ફેલિયર પેશન્ટ There is also possibility at creatinine of 1.4 or 1.5, VOC may be having eGFR of 20 or 30. So you are not sure whether erythropoietin is there or how much it is there, right? So you need to take erythropoietin as well. And if these patients are hypertensive, it is a very big disaster if you give IV iron to them, right? So bohbadi vastu aapna dhyan
rakho. Exactly.
So practically this is futile thing that we are discussing right now, but for the sake of discussion, kari lo.
This was one more which I tried with this. It was continued for 52 weeks. The IV ferric carboxymaltose was given on day 0, 6th week, 12th week, and 24th week if there was still iron deficiency. At 24 weeks, the primary endpoint was checked, which was change in 6 minute walk distance from baseline, and it was the results were calculated. On 36th week, again, iron deficiency was checked. If it was deficient, patient was replenished, and at iron for maintenance was given and we felt if there was still iron deficiency. The results was that.
So can I ask you one question?
Yes.
For any trial, the scientific question is raised first. Okay. So what is the question here? Are you treating iron deficiency or you are treating iron deficiency anemia?
Iron deficiency.
You are treating iron deficiency. એટલે એટલું આયરન તમારા હાર્ટ ને બચાવે છે જે ઉસારે કીધું એવી રીતે માયોગ્લોબિન લેવલ. ઓકે.
એનિમિયા ઇઝ નોટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ.
યા.
આઈ રેડી ફોર ધ પ્રાઇમરી. લોહી આર સંભવ છે.
Of changing PK and volume oxygen consumption from baseline was no different between FCM or control groups, but it had the secondary goals were increase in patient's global assessment and functional HI, which was increased than the standard care. From AHF trial, this was the largest trial which was studied to compare ferric carboxymaltose with placebo in patients with acute heart failure and iron deficiency. It included patients which were hospitalized with acute LVF with an EF less than 50% and who were on diuretics. They were initially evaluated for iron deficiency, but randomized to treatment with FCM versus placebo. Patients would receive the first dose of FCM prior to discharge and a second dose at 6 weeks after discharge. Subsequent doses were given if needed at 12 and 24 weeks and in patients who remained in iron deficiency, that's between.
So here you are targeting hemoglobin.
Yes,
right. So hemoglobin alone will not only increase with iron supplement. You need to give something else as well. So that is a catch point where you can understand your bakwas.
But the trial is a different criteria, different regime, everything is different.
Nobody is saying that we need to be a po, folic acid be a po, saru protein be a po, and saru hemoglobin. But iron is not a po. How it is possible scientifically?
All over the 85% of people are becoming different deficient. So if you have not provided raw material, only iron is not going to.
So એનો આન્સર એવો હશે કે આ તમે આખો ટ્રાયલ વાંચશો ને તો ક્યાંક નાના એનેક્સમાં લખ્યું હશે કે જેમાં હિમોગ્લોબિન રિસ્પોન્સ નથી મળતો એને આવી વસ્તુ આપવાની. માસ ઇમ્યુનાઇઝેશન વિથ આયરન
નેફ્રોલોજિસ્ટ
તમે માસ સ્ક્રીનિંગ કરો ને હું તમને ઉત્તમ હોય એટલો બધા મારે હું તો મારી મેક્સિમમ પ્રિસ્ક્રિપ્શન હોય ને તો લિવોજન ના છે મેક્સિમમ
ખબર છે કે એની પેટર્ન પૂરી થઈ ગઈ બે મહિના પહેલા એ ખબર પડી ને પાછું એટલે હવે બહુ વધારે
હવે સર બહુ ટ્રાયલ નહીં થાય
હવે તારે જર્મથી સ્ટોક કાઢવાનો ને આ બધો યાર જેટલો હોય એટલો
છેલ્લો એફએમમાં એ લોકોએ શું કર્યું એકચ્યુઅલી આ ટ્રાયલમાં એ લોકો ગ્રેજ્યુઅલી ક્રાઇટેરિયા એ પ્રમાણે ફિક્સ કરતા ગયા ફર્સ્ટ ટ્રાયલ એમને એવી રીતના કે ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ યુઝફુલ એટલે પછી એમને ક્રાઇટેરિયા થોડા ચેન્જ કર્યા સેકન્ડ ટ્રાયલ કર્યો અને લાસ્ટની અંદર એફએમ ટ્રાયલની અંદર એ લોકોએ કમ્પ્લીટલી હિમોગ્લોબિન આયન બંને પર ફોકસ કરી અને આ ટ્રાયલમાં કન્ક્લુઝન આપશે કે ઇટ ઇઝ વેરી ઇઝ
એટલે આ તો વેક્સિન જેવું જ છે કોરોનાનું શરૂઆતમાં 100% પ્રિવેન્શન પછી 95% પછી 94% પછી કે જે હોસ્પિટલાઇઝેશન ડિક્રીઝ થશે પછી કે છે આટલા ઇન્સિડન્સ ઓછા થશે
સાહેબ વેક્સિન વોર મૂવી જોયું સર
એ જોવા જેવું છે
ખરેખર જોયા હો બધા જોયા હો બધા
ઇટ ઇઝ મસ્ટ એવરીવન મસ્ટ
સી વોર મસ્ટ
મૂવી વેક્સિન વોર ઇટ ઇઝ મસ્ટ ટુ સી આપણે જતોય રહ્યો પણ ખબર નહીં બના ના
તો ના ના છે ચાલશે
ઓટીટી પર આવે ઓટીટી ઉપર મહિના
criteria included the mean LVF was 32% and elevated cardiovascular death. There was no change in the risk of cardiovascular death. This was the primary endpoint. Recent study was iron man. Effectiveness of intravenous iron treatment versus standard care. In standard care, they included oral iron supplementations in patients with heart failure and iron deficiency. In this trial, they had used ferric daily isomaltose on cardiovascular outcomes. The inclusion criteria included same serum ferritin less than 100 and transferrin saturation less than 20 and an LPF less than 45% or less within preceding 24 months, like in 2 years. This trial, the primary outcome was cardiovascular death or HF hospitalization for ferric daily isomaltose versus usual care, and the trial showed there was no superior to the usual care among patients in heart failure and iron deficiency. No changes in quality of life measure or walk distance were noted either, and they had blamed to COVID-19 pandemic, and due to that ferritin levels were increased to a higher extent, so they were not able to compute the required results. This was released in
just 2A.
2A. For AHA, it's 2A. Has remained 2A even in 2A.